I'd like to introduce Nate. Nate, are you there?
I'm here. How are you, everybody?
Thanks for joining us, Nate. So we've got a couple of questions that have come in, and I'm sure you're going to want to add some things to this as well. And we're going to talk about cash flow, Nate. And I know that maybe to some it's simple, others it's not. But one of the questions is, what exactly is cash flow, and really how does it differ from profitability?
Right. So, you know, cash flow can be, the definition is pretty simple. It's the money coming in and going out of your business, you know, so that part is pretty basic. You know, part of what our company does, basically the core of what we do is accounting and tax. So we've got a number of clients, number of different types of business owners, large and small. One of the things we try to drill into their minds and their heads is that, you know, you need to pay attention to the numbers. You know, you don't have to understand accounting. You don't have to have a degree, but you have to understand how the numbers work. And cash flow is kind of like the forgotten numeric. So we know about the profit and loss statement. We know about the balance sheet. Cash flow is more of what I feel is a future measure of how you're doing and how you're going to do, you know, 6 months down the road. You know, especially in this time, I don't think it's any more visual than it is now, how important it is to, you know, save for that rainy day, which we've all heard of. You know, my first exposure to that, I'm in my mid-40s, and up until the market crash, you know, 2008, 2009, I didn't understand how important, you know, saving for that rainy day was. Not that, you know, it wiped me out or anything like that. It was just a big eye-opener. Growing up, my parents would only buy cars with cash. They wouldn't finance anything. And, you know, now they're in their mid-80s, and they have seen things that at the time, you know, me thinking I knew everything, realized that I had a lot to learn. And not to go off on a tangent, but cash flow is exactly that. It's planning for the future. So you can have, you know, part of we've got positive cash flow, we've got negative cash flow. Positive cash flow obviously is more money coming in through various ways, sales, receivables, you know, that sort of thing. And then obviously the negative cash flow is more money going out than coming in.
Well, Nate, one of the questions is, I'm making profit. There's always cash in the bank. Why should I be concerned about cash flow? It looks like I'm making money, and I've got some jingle in my pocket.
Right. One of the things we probably say more than anything to our clients is don't run your business off of your bank account. There is no way you know how you're doing by looking at your bank account. Yeah, you may have cash and you may always have cash, but that doesn't necessarily mean that you're profitable as a company and that you're doing well, you know, quote unquote, the healthy business. So you can look at your profit and loss statement. Let's talk about the three, you know, what I consider the major statements. You got your profit and loss statement, your balance sheet, and your cash flow statement. Your profit and loss, the way that I best term it is, it's a measure of a certain amount of time. So whether you're looking at, you know, this week, or you're looking at the last year or the last month, it's only going to measure that time frame. The balance sheet is basically where you stand today. So from the start of your business, maybe you started your business 20 years ago. When you pull up your balance sheet this moment, that balance sheet is going to show, you know, bank account balances, loan balances, all your assets and liabilities and equity balances as they stand today. A cash flow is, like I said earlier, it's the ins and outs of the business. That's kind of like the detail behind all the profit and loss numbers and the balance sheet numbers, because you can see, you know, are you hemorrhaging? Are you losing more money than you're making? And one of the biggest things that you've got to understand is why. You've got to ask yourself those questions. Brent can attest to the fact that when we're in our meetings, I'm always talking about today as far as how are we doing today, because that's going to affect us months down the road. And we need to either adjust, or, you know, we need to put money aside, or whatever we're doing. We're always talking about today and how it's going to affect us in the future.
Well, Nate, that brings me to the next question that somebody sent in. My P&L shows I make some good profit, yet it seems as though my bank account is always short on cash to pay my bills. Is it possible to run reports that focus on cash flow? So what are those reports? What is a cash flow statement?
So the general term is the statement of cash flow. And it's exactly that. So you're going to see the in and out. You're going to see you know, where you're receiving the money from. One of the things about a profit and loss statement is, I mean, there's a variety of ways you can show a profit and not actually be profitable in regard to having the cash available to pay your next bill. So you can show a profit of, let's say, $10,000, just throwing something out there, when in reality, maybe you've spent money on a loan, or you've paid out dividends or distributions. Those aren't going to hit the profit and loss statement. Those are going to go to the balance sheet. So what you're showing is maybe you had to pay, you know, shareholders $20,000 in distributions or dividends. That $20,000 is not going to go up against that $10,000 that you're showing as being profitable. That's hitting the balance sheet. So again, those three statements all work in harmony with each other. And it's important that you know where you stand with each of those sets of numbers, because they all play a part in your health as a business.
So that would also involve if you have a loan, right, with the bank. The more that shows up on the balance statement, not in your cash flow or not in your profit and loss statement.
Correct.
Yep. So the next question is, once I calculate my cash flow statement, what should I look for, or what will it tell me? So what specific things should they look for in the cash flow statement that would help them project future needs?
Well, as I touched on earlier, obviously, the first thing you want to ask yourself, is it positive or is it negative? And why? You know, why is it positive? Maybe the sales that you're generating, you know, are profitable sales. One thing that I've said within our own company is not all sale is a good sale. You know, you may sell something, it may be a $1 million sale, a $1 billion sale, but if you're losing 1.1 on it, or, you know, the cost is higher than the sale, it's not a benefit. And that's what the cash flow statement can do for you. It can tell you, you know, this $1 million job that you just got, we've got a lot of contractors as clients, and they're floating money all the time. You know, they may start a job where, yeah, they sold it for $1 million, but all of these payments to subcontractors, materials, you know, labor, all those things actually mean they're going to lose $100,000 at the end of the day. A lot of them, you know, without even thinking about it, they're thinking about the money now. I'm going to get $1 million deposited into my account today, so I am healthy. And it takes a lot of time to ingrain in their mind that doesn't necessarily mean you're healthy. Yeah, you've got $1 million today, but you got to understand 1.1 of that is already gone. You're in the hole $100,000. So that statement of cash flows does exactly that, because you're thinking about the future. So that $1 million you just got today, what does that mean in the future? Does it mean maybe you're going to be profitable $100,000? And then that $100,000 you're profitable, what can you do with that money to invest in the future, to generate more sales, or, you know, to build up your business?
So if they're having trouble running a cash flow statement and they need to go to their accountant or a third party, what is typically involved? How much time does it take? What information do they have to give, say, a company like yours? And what would be a cost? What could they expect, generally speaking, on what it would cost to get a cash flow statement or an analysis done?
So the cost is a hard question to answer. You know, we obviously, being in the industry we're in, we know, you know, competitors ourselves, how things are priced out there. You've got firms that will bill you by the hour. You've got firms that will bill you a flat rate, and it just runs all over the dartboard. The way that we bill is we do a flat rate, and before we decide what that is, we ask for all the information. So in a situation like this, you know, the cash flow statement isn't something you can just simply create, you know, in a matter of minutes. It's a full accounting, because again, you want not only the statement of cash flows, you want the balance sheet and the profit and loss as well. Because one statement isn't going to tell you all you need to know. You need to have the full accounting. So what we do as a firm, and not all firms do, this is just what we do. We do the flat rate. And the reason we do that is, and Bruno, you know, no offense to you as an attorney, but we have an attorney that we have to pay by the hour. And I don't like the fact that when I call, I feel like I've got a rush, or I don't want to call because I don't want to ask him a 2-minute question and get billed for the 15 minutes. You know, I don't want our clients to feel that way. So we've done it to where it's a flat rate. We tell them right in the beginning what they're looking at by gathering all the statements and figuring out how much time it's going to take us. And it's not just a one-time thing. You know, I've always said a good accountant is going to pay for themselves. And they do that through giving business owners visualization advice, a number of different ways. You know, we do the accounting and the tax along with it. So we're doing tax planning at the same time we're doing the accounting, which is a benefit that our clients, you know, really, really like, and we get a lot of referrals because of that. So the cost part is a hard question to answer. And then as far as the developing of it, like I said, it's something, you know, like if somebody came to us today and wanted to start from today, we would definitely want to go back to January because we want to show them an entire year if they've been in business. If they're starting as of now, then obviously it would be now going forward, you know, what is it going to be? And we grow with our clients as they grow. Some of our clients go down and our rates adjust accordingly because we're not going to overbill or underbill, you know, because our clients do well or don't do well.
Well, in wrapping this session up with you, Nate, today, a tactical measure that they should take, even if it's not a sophisticated or a complicated one, they need to look at their cash position and look at what their cash needs are going to be for the next 30, 60, 90 days and get ahead of that cash flow problem. If it looks like they're not going to be able to make a payment, they need to, we're going to talk about this a little bit later as well, but they need to get ahead of it, talk to their lenders, talk to their banks, talk to their landlords, and talk this problem through. Just don't let it creep up on you because then other problems are gonna manifest itself. This month of April, every day for 30 days, I'm putting on, I'm posting on our Facebook page one way to improve your cash flow. Yesterday, I talked about calculating the gross profit margin, and today and the rest of the month, every day, I'm gonna give ideas on what you can do to improve your cash flow. So Nate, in closing, is there anything else that you'd like to throw out there or say before we bring up the next panelist?
Just something real quickly, you know, again, as business owners, you need to know your numbers. You don't need to understand debits and credits and all those things, but like we encourage all of our clients, understand where your numbers are coming from and how they're going to affect you today and in the future. You know, again, this is a great time to kind of step back and reevaluate everything you've got going on, you know, in your personal life, your business life, in regard to your finances and all that. This really exposes, you know, where you've been and how you've been doing things. If you've been doing things the right way, then maybe you're not feeling the effects like a lot of other businesses are in regard to having saved for that rainy day, preparing for these, you know, three-month shutdown, however long it's going to be. But you've done the work to get to where you are, to where maybe it's not affecting you as much as others. And I'm talking about businesses that have been completely shut down, you know, where they have prepared for this day, where 3 months from now or however long it's going to be, they can start right up running from the very beginning and take off.
All right, Nate, thank you very much. I appreciate it. I know you valuable time out, but we wish you well. And again, thanks for joining us.